Italian Football Lover channel, my friends. Roma won 3-0 against Udinese. I want to talk about the tactics and analysis of this game. Let's start with Roma tactics. In Roma, Veratu scored 2 goals, one of them from penalty, and Pedro scored 1 goal in the last minute of the game. Roma played in 3-4-3 Paulo Fonseca's classical formation, and in Roma attacks, Karstorp and Spinazzola came to forward and support the attacks together. When Karstorp and Spinazzola came to forward, Pellegrini and Mkhitaryan came to middle and got into the penalty area, forced the Udinese defense. And Borja Mayoral played close to defender Neuting. And in Roma, sometimes in the corner kicks and free kicks, Mancini and Ibanez came to forward and got into the box and searched for the goal positions. And in the first goal of Roma, Mancini came to forward and he centered the ball into the penalty area. Veratut scored the goal with his head, and Veratut scored one more goal from penalty, and goalkeeper Musso touched the Mkhitaryan, fall down, and the referee gave penalty. Veratut scored the second goal of Roma from the penalty. And Roma played so effective and made so much pressure. And in Roma, Villar played more defensively and close to defense line. And at the same time, Villar played close to Rodrigo De Paul on the midfield. And Veratut carried the balls to the forward. And Roma made counterattacks with Veratut at the same time. Pellegrini and Mkhitaryan, they are so fast players and came to forward together. And every time Veratut got into the penalty area and searched for the goal positions, one ball Veratut brought from the left and gave his pass into the box. Pellegrini scored the goal. He came from the right and scored the goal. But this goal was disallowed by the referee. And the first half was finished 2-0. And in Roma, when Ibanez came to forward, Spinazzola stayed on the back and replaced of Ibanez, and every time Mancini and Ibanez tried to headshots in Udinese box, and some substitutions made by Paulo Fonseca in the second half for Roma. First substitution, Borja Mayoral out on the forward, and Dzeko replaced of him. And after Veratut out and Pedro in, after this substitution, Pedro played on the right forward, and Pellegrini played in the position of Veratut. Pellegrini played here, and after Paulo Fonseca made two more substitutions, and Spinazzola out on the left of the midfield, and Bruno Perez replaced of Spinazzola. Bruno Perez played on the left wing, and last substitution for Roma, Lorenzo Pellegrini out, Diawara in, and Diawara and Villar played on the midfield together close to end of the game. Diawara, and this substitution made Roma's midfield stronger defensively, and Roma found the last goal in the last minutes of the game with Pedro's shot, and the score was 3-0 with this goal, and Roma won and deserved this game 3-0. Secondly, I want to talk about Udinese's tactics, and Udinese started the game very bad. But Udinese played defensively in the beginning of the game, and Roma made so much pressure on Udinese defense with Pellegrini, Mkhitaryan, Veratut, and from the wings, Karstorp and Spinazzola supported the attacks together. Roma scored 2 goals in the beginning of the game, as in the first half. And Udinese played every time 3-5-2 formation. And in Udinese, Rodrigo De Paul is a real star. And every time he played more offensively, he carried the balls to the forward. And he gave good passes between of Roma defense. At the same time, De Paul give good long passes to the forward. And at the same time, Tolgay Arslan played more defensively. He played close to defense line. Wallace played a little bit front of Tolgay Arslan, a little bit more offensively. And in the defense, Noitink played close to forward Borja Mayoral, and Llorente and Delefoe made press on Roma defense, and Llorente played close to Cristante more. But in the first half, Udinese was so ineffective, and the first half was finished 2-0. And in the second half, Udinese's coach Gotti made some substitutions, and first substitutions for Udinese, Stricer Larsen out on the right, and Molina in. Molina played on the right, and Llorente out on the forward. Okaka replaced of him. And after these substitutions, Udinese developed attacks with De Paul, and Delefoe was so effective. Sometimes Delefoe came close to right, sometimes he came close to left, and he made press on Roma defense, and Delefoe found a few goal positions, but missed all of them. And Okaka and Delefoe played close to each other, and Luca Gotti made another substitutions for Udinese, and Zegeler out on the left wing, and Ovean replaced of him. Ovean and Tolgay Arslan out on the midfield, and at the same time Wallace out, Makengo and forward Nestorovski got into the pitch. After these substitutions, Makengo played on the center of the midfield together Rodrigo De Paul, and Udinese's formation turned into 3-4-3, and Delefoe, Okaka and Nestorovski played on the forward like this. Delefoe, Nestorovski. These three changed their positions between each other. Sometimes Nestorovski came to right, sometimes Delefoe came to left, Okaka came to center. And but Udinese couldn't find a goal against Roma, and Roma won and deserved this game. All my analyses and all my comments like this about Roma Udinese game. You can write your suggestions and comments under my video. Please open up your notification links, notification bells. You can subscribe to my channel, watch my videos. Thank you very much. See you on my next videos. Bye.